Beth was placed around 0:00 hours and 7 minutes with conditions favorable for DNA sample recovery. We had some initial concerns about interference in the vault, but given the skill and talent of this team, we were able to capture useful data. I personally retrieved the subject's backpack and extracted a number of objects of interest to undergo detailed analysis. The subject displayed burns to the right hand, severe enough to fuse the bones, indicating some kind of spontaneous, intense burn trauma. Honestly, we've never seen anything like it before. Head, neck, and torso remained in good condition. I hand-selected recovery agents to retrieve fluid samples, blood and saliva. We then commenced material extraction and were able to preserve several exemplary samples. Data analysis and sequencing is already underway, and I'm told proceeding with exceptional ease thanks to the cloud database and the work of Abstergo Sample Recovery Unit 3. The legacy of Subject 17 will continue uninhibited as Sample 17. December 23rd, 2012. Sample recovery.
Oh, you're better at this than I'd hoped. Now zip on down to the lobby. Come on. See? That file you acquired? I wouldn't recommend watching it. I mean, you could, but it's unpleasant. So once you hand it off, just pretend this never happened, okay? Otherwise, you'll just go to bed feeling sad. Anyway, the courier should be waiting downstairs. She's been here a while.
December 23rd, 2012.
It goes without saying, just because you now know how to hack all your colleagues' computers, it doesn't mean you should. I mean, not every day, right? No, seriously, though, that's illegal, so don't be a dick. Unless that's your nature.
I am not sure I can keep this up, you know? This job is well below my skill level.
Yeah, well, your coffee is shit. You could use some practice.
What? No, no, no. I followed that recipe to the letter. Oh, look who's here. So you didn't forget, after all. You're just incredibly rude and made poor Rebecca here wait for nearly 30 minutes.
You limey. Be nice. Sorry about him. He's high on his own supply. So, how should we do this? Data transfer? Great. That should do it. We'll email you the receipt. Till next time. Take care, Sean.
Bye-bye, yes, bye. And don't expect any more free coffee. Arrogant. She's great, isn't she?
Hey, I just got word the courier has come and gone. Wonderful, you're a miracle. No, that's an exaggeration. You're not a miracle. You're an employee. Doing a job. But thanks for helping out. Anyway, thanks. Have fun pirating.
Assistance au niveau 2, projet échantillon 17. Support to the second floor, sample 17 project.
Oi. Where you going, the market?
No, I... My parents have asked me to come live with them, and I'd like to.
Oh, what do you mean, live with them? You live here with me.
I'm sorry, Edward, but my father is right. You had a decent wage when you worked the farm. Why can you not be satisfied with that? With me?
Decent wage? That job was near as, damn it, to robbery. You want to be married to a peasant the whole of your life?
All right, Edward. All right.
You leave now, Caroline. You'll never know what's coming to us. Caroline!
Wake up, can we?
What's that about?
He left this morning with the galleon. As faith, we'll discover a good use for this old cove ourselves.
Aye, we'll make something of it in time. We could keep a fleet here if we liked. And with a bit of fixing up, it'd be a decent place to call home. Might even convince my wife to come one day.
You're married, are you?
In God's eyes, I am. She left me some time ago.
Even so, keep that fact hid away. Most of these pirates don't respect a man with higher commitments than rum and plunder.
Upon mine honor. Let me know if you find anything.
You must see this. Come on, man.
Odd looking things, aren't they? Old and weathered.
Is this what they call Mayan? Or is it Aztec?
Are you good with riddles, Edward? Puzzles and ponderings and the like.
No worse than the next man, why?
I think you've a natural gift for it. The way you think and work. The way you understand the world.
Well, I don't know about that. You're talking in riddles now and I don't understand a word.
Clamber on top of this thing here, will you? Help me solve something.
Concentrate and focus all your senses. Look past shadow and sound, deep into matter, until you see and hear a kind of shimmering.
A shimmering?
You understand?
I think so. I've seen its like before, glowing like moonlight on the ocean. Ah, right, I know this feeling. I have since I was a lad. It's like using every sense of...
Woman on this earth has in them a kind of intuition hidden deep away.
You are a gifted man, Edward.
Has a strange look. Is it worth something?
Nothing you can spend. But if you find all of them, it'll lead to something grand.
How many?
A few dozen, I think. This way. I've something else to show you.
Something else just here. I think you'll take it for this.
Now this has the makings of a mystery.
It's good, innit? Only wait till you see what lies at the end.
I think Monsieur Ducasse was a man of many secrets.
Aye, and look here. A solid staircase leading God knows where. What do you suppose lies at the top?
From what I knew of Decas, I wouldn't be surprised to find eclectic instruments of torture and villainy. An Iron Maiden or a collection of thumbscrews.
Or a pair of anguish.
Not a nice way to kick off. But that is some damn fine gear.
Try the key you took from Ducasse.
That's one. Only four left.
Aye. It might be that these four Templars have them. See the names here? They've been sent to kill these four targets.
Hang me, that's the map I sold to Governor Torres in Havana. He said it marked the location of assassin encampments.
You think maybe you owe them a bit of warning, then? If you have any kind of heart beating in that chest.
Suppose I could. If it leads me to the four other keys.
Bad excuse is better than none at all.
Leaving already?
I think this cove suits you best, Edward. Better than that costume does.
Oh, come on now. We're pirates, kid. We take as we please and become who we like. Self-made men.
But that look ain't you. It's not who you are.
Who am I, then?
Hard to tell some days. All I know is you like dangerous prizes.
Like the observatory? I think you know more about that than you let on in Nassau.
You noticed that, did you? Meet me at 20 degrees, 3 minutes latitude, just off the coast of Yucatan. I'll have something to show you there in a few weeks' time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. my word, sir. I've been needing coin to set up the shipyard, Captain. The faster we have the needful gold, the sooner our ships will rule the waves. What have you been eating today, then? My thanks for your trust, Captain.
Spare me your jugs, just a wee bit. The men do sorely lack a place to do their wenching and debauching. With a little coin encouragement, I could have the old place Bristol fashion and a flow of rum fit to obliterate a good tar proper like. You've done an old salt proud, Captain. Be making it worth your while, too.
Got an ear for me, Captain.
I'll not play duck and drag with you, Captain. I need coin to build a little emporium. I'd be ever obliged. And a local shop would bring in many a useful ware for you as repayment.
A pleasure.
Vraiment.
Excellent. Merci, mon ami.
Been thinking, Captain. Why not build ourselves a grand old bonfire by the beach? The lads would be a better cheer if they had such a spot to let loose. You savvy?
that booty.
Ahoy, Captain. A trove of nautical maps and ledgers and the like, scattered about the village. You'll find them sorted in the captain's quarters of the Jackdaw. Quality stuff.
Nautical maps and ledgers. My camp.
Today, Captain. It's a fine day for any kind of mischief.
What's your feeling?
I'll make no secret of wanting to see the British brought to heel. If we can take their gold and put it to use ourselves, I'd be a happy man.
Spoken like a true Welshman, Addy.
And what's your aim?
Master Kidd hinted at a prize he was eager to show me down in Tulum. Quite some distance, mind, on the Yucatan Peninsula.
You trust him to play it fair?
I can't be sure. He has a way of pecking away at my conscience that gives me pause. I should go see him soon.
So long as we take some prizes along the way. I'm sure the crew will understand. I'll set a course for Tulum.
Harbin Command! Pass the way! The clues up! Eat her sticks!
Thank you.
today, Captain. It's a fine day for any kind of mischief.
What's your feeling?
I'll make no secret of wanting to see the British brought to heel. If we can take their gold and put it to use ourselves, I'd be a happy man.
Spoken like a true Welshman, Ade.
And what's your aim?
Master Kidd hinted at a prize he was eager to show me down in Taroom. Quite some distance, mind, from the Yucatan Peninsula.
You trust him to play fair?
I can't be sure. He has a way of picking away at my conscience that gives me pause. I should go see him soon.
So long as we take some prizes along the way, I'm sure the crew will understand. I'll set a course for Tulum.
And so